Let's import the creator base set. Go to File, Import, FBX. Now that the creator base set is here, you first have to unbind the mask from the armature. The armature is the bone-like structures that you can see here. We don't need to use them now, but we need them in the final stages of creating our item. That topic is popularly called as rigging, and it would be on another video so as not to confuse you with a lot of information. To unbind the mask from the armature, select the mask, press Shift, and select the armature. Then right-click, Parent, Clear and Keep Transformation. On the collection area, or what we call the outliner, you will now see that the mask and the armature were already unbound because they now have separate lines. One thing to remember in 3D modeling is that you have to use the resources available to make your object look as close to the reference or your idea as possible. To create the skirt, I will use the cylinder mesh provided here in Blender. So go here in Add, Mesh, Cylinder. After adding the cylinder, let's go to Edit Mode. Delete the top and bottom face by going into Face Select or number 3 on your keyboard. After that, switch back to Vertex Select or number 1 on your keyboard. Select all the bottom vertices alternately. You can also have the choice to select the vertices one by one or use the shortcut key. Select these two vertices with one vertex skip in the middle, then press Ctrl, Shift, and the plus sign in your number pad. It will automatically select the vertices alternately as you press it. After that, go to the top view by pressing the Z in the gizmo or the number 7 in your number pad. Scale the selected vertices inward by pressing S and moving your mouse. After scaling, rotate it to whatever direction you like to turn. For me, I'll rotate it this way. It starts to form pleats if you try to view how it looks. So now, we're just going to adjust the waist part. Go to the front view, then select all the top vertices. Remember to enable X-ray by this button or pressing Alt and Z so that the vertices at the back will be selected as well. Scale it up to the size of the waist. After that, let's just adjust the size of the overall skirt by moving the top and bottom vertices at the length that I want. Then, I will make some adjustments by using the Move tool here. Do not worry if the skirt is protruding in the mask. As you can see, the skirt still looks broad and bloated, so I am going to scale it based on its axis. If you want it to be less broad, you can scale it by pressing S, then X. If you're going to make it less bloated, press S and Y. Now let's make the topology. It will be hard for us to control the mesh with just the bottom and top vertices, so we will add more. In Edit Mode, find the Loop Cut tool on the left side of the screen. If you want to see the names of the tools, just simply expand the tabs. Then, I will place a couple of loop cuts here to have a good topology. Topology is how the spacing and arrangement of your components such as face, vertex, and edge look. But remember our polycount, don't put too much loop cuts. As you can see, there are a lot of open vertices here on the top part, so to make the topology cleaner, we're just going to merge the vertices to decrease our poly count as well. To do that, you have to select the vertices by pair and then press M to merge at center. You have to do it by pair since if you select the vertices all together, it will look like this. And we don't want that. So just proceed to do this until the end of the loop. Then, let's create this belt part right here by selecting the top vertices and then pressing E to extrude in the Z axis. E, then Z. As you noticed in object mode, the edges are creasing in the mesh and we don't want that. So click the skirt, then right click, shade smooth. The creasing edges now disappeared, but our mesh turned darker for some reason. The culprit for the darkening of the mesh is the normals. To fix the normals, go to Edit Mode, Mesh, Normals, Average, Face Area. Press Alt N, Average, Face Area for the shortcut key. This applies not only because you shaded your mesh smooth, but also to the instances that you extrude. If you did not fix the darkening, it would appear in ZEPETO and I find that not appealing at all. The belt part that we created was also made less emphasized because it became smooth. So to emphasize the belt, go to Edit Mode and then Edge Select. Select the edges around the waist and right-click Mark Sharp. Some features are only available in specific component selection, so be sure you follow whenever I say switch to between vertex, edge, and face select. And then if you go back to object mode, everything turns back to normal. If you have no more additional fixing for your skirt, we can now assign a material to it. A material is where we will put our textures or designs in Unity. So click the skirt, then go here in the material properties. Click new, then change the name of the material by double-clicking it from material 0.001 to skirt underscore SHD. We have to put SHD for every material that we will use to familiarize ourselves with the materials once we go to Unity and for organization purposes. You can pause this video if you want additional fixing for your skirt, but if none, we will now proceed to the underwear of the skirt. For the skirts and dresses, you are required to put underwear in them. Otherwise, ZEPETO will reject your item and will be deemed as incomplete. To create the underwear, we will be extracting that from the mask. I'm just going to hide the skirt so it won't go in the way by clicking this eye button here. To duplicate, select the mask and then press Shift and D as in D for duplicate. Do not move your mouse so that the duplicated object will not move as well. Just hit enter so that the original and duplicate will have the same location. Now, going back to the outliner here, you will know that you have successfully duplicated the object by its name, which is this 0.001 added next to it. Next is, I will change the name of the duplicated object so that I will not be confused later on. Simply double-click on the name of the duplicated object in the outliner and just type the name already. So mine is I will change it to shorts. Be careful with the naming conventions here. The original mask should not have 0.001 or other names in it aside from mask, because once we export it, it will create a clone in Unity or you won't be able to convert it into a prefab at all. Now that we're here, let's also change the name of the cylinder to skirt. In creating shorts or underwear, I will delete all the vertices surrounding the crotch and hips area so that the shape that will remain is shorts. As simple as that. And right now, the shorts are too close to the skin, and if your avatar moves even for a slight movement, the shorts will have holes in it. To avoid that, I am going to layer it. Select the shorts, go to sculpt mode, and find the layer brush. You can adjust the brush radius by pressing F, then moving your mouse. You can also change the strength, it's up to you. Then I'm just going to tap the layer brush in the shorts until it has enough space between the skin and the shorts. After that, I will extrude by pressing E, the bottom vertices of the shorts, and press S. E, then S. Then just move your mouse a little bit. And here is what it looks like. I made this so that there is no need to thicken or solidify the shorts anymore because it will just add extra polygons that we don't need. Now, let's fix this darkness around the shorts. I have already averaged the normal of the shorts, however, the darkness still hasn't changed. This darkness was caused by extruding the vertices inward. To fix this, go into edit mode, then edge select. Select the edges around the bottom of the shorts, and then right click, mark sharp. And there you go, the normals are now fixed. Again, we have to assign a material by going into the material properties. However, we need to remove the existing material because remember, we made the shorts using the mask. And if we don't change this, the mask and the shorts will have the same material. We have to click the minus sign on the side, then click new to change. Change the material to shorts SHD. You have to do this method whenever you make an item out of a mask. When it comes to the joining of the objects made from the mask and objects created from the mesh in Blender, we have to select the object made from the mesh in Blender first, which is the skirt, then followed by the object made from the mask, which is the shorts. Then press Ctrl+J to join the two meshes. This is to prevent the slanting of your object when it comes to Unity so that it won't have any abnormal appearance when we export it. The properties set by ZEPETO on the mask will be shared with the mesh in Blender. That's it for this video. I hope you learned something new for today. See you in the next one. Bye!